Hello friends, in our last class we have completed two types differential diagnosis of dementia. One being frontotemporal dementia, which we have seen in our last class, and the other being multi-infarct dementia and white matter disease. So in this lecture I would like to discuss about the other cause of frontotemporal dementia, other differential diagnosis of dementia, which include progressive supranuclear palsy. Right, progressive supranuclear palsy. It is also called as, okay, so first you see the clinic, just a minute. So here in progressive supranuclear palsy, there is degenerative disease which involves brainstem, basal ganglia, limbic structures, and cortex. So these are the areas which are involved. So now clinical features here, there is a male who is elderly and he manifests with, he falls, he falls abruptly, he falls suddenly, and then he has changes in personality changes. So what personality changes do you expect? You can see mental rigidity, impulsivity, and apathy are seen. And after that, these are the first changes that you see. After falling for certain times, then you see a disorder which is called as progressive oculomotor syndrome, where there is a difficulty in watching things and understanding things. So here he sees slowly there will be square wave jerks, and these are followed by slowed saccades, which are worse on vertically when compared to horizontally. So these are seen, and this later leads to progressive supranuclear ophthalmoparesis in severe forms. But then the patient develops dysarthria, dysphagia, and he also develops symmetric axial rigidity. So he cannot have rigid, he cannot move the body, he has rigidity. So because of symmetric axial rigidity, he adopts a posture which is very stiff. One minute, let me draw you that posture. A stiff, unstable posture with hyperextension of the neck. Hyperextension of the neck. So this posture is called as toppling gait. Toppling gait. Right? So because of this rigidity, because of axial rigidity and loss of judgment, and limited ocular movements, all these leads to frequent unexplained falls. He starts falling down. Just unexplainedly, he just stands over there and he falls. That's it. and explained spectacular falls. Right? And then he develops progressive supranuclear ophthalmoparesis. That is paresis of eye muscles. So there is limited voluntary eye movements. He cannot move the eyes properly. So there is limited voluntary eye movements and they retain oculocephalic reflexes. So such a face is demonstrated using a maneuver which is called as doll's head maneuver. Right? So this is the characteristic feature of progressive supranuclear palsy. This is completely different from Alzheimer's disease, right? It has many different things. It has involvement of eye movements, which is very specific. That is the difference between this and Alzheimer's disease. So now here you see neurofibrillary tangles are seen. Just like Alzheimer's disease, neurofibrillary tangles are seen. These are large here and spherical. These tau inclusions which are seen are called as globose tangles here. Where are they found? They are found in subcortical structures. They are found in subcortical structures. Like subthalamic nucleus. They are found in subthalamic nucleus. Globus pallidus. Substantia nigra. Locus ceruleus and periaqueductal gray matter, and they are also found in superior colliculi and oculomotor nucleus. Right? So microscopically, if you see these tangles, which are called as progressive supranuclear palsy tangles, they have straight tubules. But if you see in Alzheimer's disease, they have helical filaments, which are paired. So in Alzheimer's there are helical filaments and in PSP they are straight. This is helical. This is progressive supranuclear palsy. This is Alzheimer's disease. This is the major differentiating feature between Alzheimer's disease and progressive supranuclear palsy, other than history wise. So, here in progressive supranuclear palsy, there is difficulty, as I have said, limited voluntary movements, and mostly there is upward gaze restriction. Right? And then, so this is about the progressive supranuclear palsy. So here the only characteristic feature is development of ocular features and then stiffness, rigidity, and later finally on histology you can see the difference of tubules of filaments in Alzheimer's disease and in progressive supranuclear palsy. Thank you guys for watching my lecture. If you feel something is inadequate in this lecture, please comment it in the comment section. If you feel there is some mistake, even then, comment it in the comment section. Thank you guys for watching my lecture, and thank you.